This video is a review of cell energy, topic 3.4 of AP Biology. What is a metabolic pathway? What are autotrophs? Compare and contrast photoautotrophs with chemoautotrophs. Describe the structure and function of ATP. Explain how ATP can be used to store and release energy. What is energy coupling? I'm Mr. W from learn-biology.com, where we believe that successful learning requires interaction and feedback, and we're so sure of that that a subscription to our website comes with a money-back guarantee. What is a metabolic pathway? A metabolic pathway is a linked series of enzyme-catalyzed chemical reactions occurring within a cell. So here you can see that these are all separate reactions, but they're linked together. Above, 1, 2, and 3 are all enzymes. A is the initial reactant. B and C are what we call intermediates, and D is the final product. Examples of metabolic reactions that you'll come to know well include glycolysis, the Krebs cycle, the Calvin cycle, all of which we'll deal with in this unit. And these reactions can be linear. So glycolysis is a linear reaction. You have a beginning point and an end point, or they can be cyclical, like the Krebs cycle and the Calvin cycle. So for example, in the Krebs cycle, this compound over here, oxaloacetate, it's the beginning compound, gets modified, and it also comes back and it's the ending compound. A similar thing happens in the Calvin cycle. What are autotrophs? Compare and contrast photoautotrophs with chemoautotrophs. Autotrophs are organisms that can produce their own food. We are not autotrophs, but plants and certain bacteria and archaea are. So photoautotrophs include plants and cyanobacteria. They use the energy and light to create organic compounds that they need to survive through photosynthesis, whereas chemoautotrophs include some bacteria, some archaea. Archaea is that third domain. The energy for their life processes comes from a process called chemosynthesis, and that involves oxidizing inorganic substances, including iron, sulfur, or hydrogen sulfide. What are heterotrophs, and how do they get the energy and matter they need to live, grow, and reproduce? Heterotrophs capture the energy present in organic compounds produced by other organisms. They can be ecological consumers, decomposers, or parasites, and they get their energy and matter by metabolizing the organic compounds and organisms that they eat or absorb, or in the dead remains of other organisms. Here's a heterotroph, and here's another heterotroph. What's the difference between an exergonic reaction and an endergonic reaction? Exergonic reactions release energy and increase entropy. So here's an exergonic reaction over here, and the energy of the reactants is less than the energy of the products. And you can't see this, but like, for example, if you burn a piece of paper or a piece of wood, you start with cellulose over here, and you wind up with many unorganized atoms of carbon dioxide and water. So that's an increase in entropy because you've decreased organization. Cellular respiration, most hydrolysis reactions are exergonic reactions. Endergonic reactions require energy and decrease entropy, and examples include photosynthesis or almost any dehydration synthesis reaction. Are you asking yourself, how am I going to get a 4 or a 5 on the AP Bio exam? It's a good question because it's a hard test, but we have a plan for your success. Go to learn-biology.com, sign up for a free trial, and complete our interactive tutorials and interactive AP Bio exam reviews. We guarantee you a 4 or a 5 on the AP Bio exam. See you on learn-biology.com. Describe the structure and function of ATP. Explain how ATP can be used to store and release energy. The structure of ATP involves a 5-carbon sugar that's called a ribose, a nitrogenous base that's called adenine, and 3 phosphate groups. The function of ATP is to power work within cells. Every cell makes its own ATP. There's no sharing of ATP between cells. And to store energy, what happens is that cells take energy from food during cellular respiration or light during photosynthesis and use that to combine ADP and a phosphate group into ATP. And to release energy for work, cells remove a phosphate group from ATP. They break off this terminal phosphate group, and that creates ADP and phosphate, and that makes energy available to do cellular work. What is energy coupling? Energy coupling is the linking of an exergonic reaction to an endergonic reaction, and that linking drives the endergonic reaction forward. Here's an example. Cellular respiration, which is exergonic, drives the formation of ATP from ADP and phosphate. So this exergonic reaction is driving this endergonic one. And example number two is the exergonic conversion of ADP and P is coupled to endergonic processes such as active transport. We discussed that in our Unit 2 review video that takes energy. So ATP to ADP and phosphate makes this endergonic reaction possible, or muscle contraction, also an endergonic reaction. It's made possible by the breakdown of ATP to ADP and phosphate. Want to learn more? Sign up for a free trial of the website that guarantees your AP Biology success. Learn-biology.com and watch this next